Just buy it and bring it. We don't even do special program for cheers. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
All right, today, briefly, I want to speak to us on what I titled Self-Control to Reach the Mark. Everybody repeat that after me.
Self-control to reach the mark.
One more time.
Self-control
to reach the mark. In life, you are going nowhere if you have no targets. In life, you are going nowhere if you have no goal. If you don't have a mark, a bar that is set, you become a wanderer and a roaming person. And I want you to understand that to roam is very expensive. Anybody ever travel in a room with that number? When you are in Liberia and you are receiving calls, it's free. But when you are roaming and you are receiving calls, you pay. You pay higher price. When you are calling, you pay. You pay higher price. Roaming is expensive. I've done that several times. And if you don't have a goal, you don't have a target, you don't have a mark in life, your life can become a roaming life. So we need to set a bar. All you need to recognize that the bar, the mark, the target that God has called you to, the only way you can get there is by self-control. You could even set a mark for yourself. You could even set a bar for yourself that by the grace of God, you want to reach in life. But I tell you, no matter what it is, if you don't have self-control, you will get nowhere. The reason why I'm so moved by the Spirit of God to teach a little bit on this today, being the first Sunday of December, is because I have come to realize that so many persons can lie on the devil. And anyone who keep lying on the devil, that person can't go anywhere in life. Imagine Satan already bound and almost responsible for everything. Then you lie on him when he didn't do something. Tell your neighbor, say, don't lie on Satan. Many persons are not accomplishing anything in life because they are used to lying on the devil. When they decide not to exhibit self-control and they get into problems and they are overwhelmed by issues that they could solve just by self-control, then they begin to point to Satan. And I think I told you this story before. I was telling the people in Nigeria, and they were laughing, and they said, why Nigeria? One time, Satan was passing in from one church, and he decided to rest. He sat down in front of the church, and he heard the woman give him a testimony. She said, my people are the devil fool me. Imagine, I just told you I was in Nigeria last week. I was not even in Liberia. So she said, I'm full. Imagine they were in Nigeria. So the Nigerian boy asked why he was in Nigeria, that different country. I said, I went to visit plenty. You understand what I'm saying? Is omnipresent, and that is God.
Amen.
As He is with us in this church right now, He is with every good church.
Amen.
Satan is not omnipresent, even though he assigns his demons, but the demons doesn't have power to do everything. There are some things Satan said that will be there. Some of the crimes that some of you commit, as Satan said, were there with you. And there are times that when he's not around, then you want to blame him for it. Only because you do not have self-control. Somebody say self-control.
Self-control.
Let's look at 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 19 to 27. 1 Corinthians chapter 9. If I don't finish with you, I will finish it. I like this version when I saw the children reading it. I am a free man, nobody's slave, but I make myself everybody's slave in order to win as many people as possible. Can you see that? Eh? I am a free man. I am nobody's slave. But I can make myself everybody's slave just to win. In order to win as many people as possible. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus, for though I be free from all men, yet have I made myself servant unto all, that I might gain the more. Verse 20. I pray that by the time we start next year, we'll have one screen somewhere for me to read. While working with the Jews, I live like a Jew in order to win them. And even though I myself am not subject to the law of Moses, but I live as though I were when working with those who are, and in order to win them. Next. In the same way, when working with Gentiles, I live like a Gentile outside the Jewish law, in order to win Gentiles. This does not mean that I don't obey God's law. I am really under Christ's law. Let's go further. Among the weak in faith, I become weak like one of them. In order to win them, so I become all things to all people, that I may save some of them by whatever means I possible. Go ahead. All this I do for the gospel's sake, in order to share in its blessing. Let's go to the next verse. Surely you know that many runners take part in race, but only one of them wins the prize. Run then in such a way as to win the prize. Are you following what Paul is saying? Every athlete in training submits to strict discipline in order to be crowned with a wreath, that is crown, that will not last, but we do it for one that will last forever. Those who discipline themselves in order to win the prize of the race. They are doing everything to win a corruptible crown. Something that will decay. Something that will break. Something that will pass away. But as for us, we are going to get what? Something that is incorruptible. Paul. That is why, run straight for the finish line. And that is why I am like a boxer who does not waste his punches. He has targets. You're not just punching in the air. You're not fighting the wind. You have targets. But listen, Paul says, when it comes to the Jew, he becomes like a Jew to them. When it comes to the Gentile, he becomes like the Gentile, but yet not just doing what they do, but he obey the law of God because he's under the law of Christ. Is somebody open?
Amen.
But what I'm saying is that Paul was qualified in several ways by God's grace, placed in certain class, but because of self-control, Paul could bring himself to any level to work with anybody. Is somebody hearing me?
Amen.
Yes. He could do it. Then he compared everything to race. He said there are many that run in a race, but only one person can receive the prize. And he went on to tell us, so if you are running to receive the prize, then you should what? Discipline yourself. You should have self-control. I studied about this guy. Is it Elizabeth? He was a boxer. And think about this version used boxing. Evangel Holyfield. When he was preparing in his boxing career, he trained for 8 hours every day. He went to the gym. He did all the exercises. He was very disciplined to go there 8 hours a day for 6 days a week. And he did it for 8 years. And he won the championship, the heavyweight boxing championship. Self-control. How many of us can discipline yourself like that? Even Pastor Wally is our own gym. Certain time you can break down when you move yourself. But Holofi decided that he will go 8 hours a day for 8 years. And he got what he wanted because he was able to discipline himself. He said, when you are running the race, you see, when you are jogging, if we are jogging now, you know when you're just jogging and you're not going anywhere, you're just jogging for exercise. You can speak to everybody sitting on the road. Yeah, my man, so how they did? And the prophetess, how are you? Prophetess Deborah, how they did? But when you are running for a prize, do you have a chance to speak to people? What do? You are running with what? Speed. And when people are calling your name, do you turn back to answer them? Do you even say, yeah, I'll call you back? Self-control is necessary when you need a prize. When you have a goal, you have a target, self-control is necessary. Why many are not succeeding is because they do not have self-control. Everything in the Word of God is connected to self-control. Is somebody hearing me?
Yes.
So Paul said, the one that is running for prize, they are very disciplined. So he said, I don't fight like somebody hitting the air. I go for targets. And to do that, you've got to be disciplined. Paul said, I can make myself. That is self-control. If you can control yourself, you can make yourself anything. There are some people, they don't call them bishop. They say, you are eating up your destiny. You call me pastor? You can't be anything to everybody. What a difference between bishop and pastor. There are even some pastors that are doing far more than bishop. Papa, are they going? The men will get one of the largest congregation in the whole world from Redeem, from Church of God. Who has a high congregation even in Nigeria? Every street you see about three different churches on every street, Redeem Church. You stay for Pastor Adeboye. He never took bishop title. How many bishops on the earth today are close to that man accomplishment? Then when somebody call you pastor, you vest. Because some men and women be sure they post them in a phony gown. But Paul said, as much as I am what I am, I know how to be like a Jew to the Jews. I know how to be a Gentile unto the Gentiles. Even though whatever level I bring myself, I still remind myself that I'm under law and it's the law of Christ.
Amen.
That is self-control. But this is what I learned. Let's move on. Let me see how the good news put verse 27. Okay, that verse 27 here. Yeah. He said, I had in my body with blows and bring it under complete control to keep myself from being disqualified after having called others to the contest. Look at what the good you see. I had in my body with blows and bring it under complete control. In the original version, the King James Version, it says that what? I bring my body under subjection. Are you following the English?
Yes.
What does the English say? I bring my body under subjection. It means that your body is not you. Your body is subject to you. Is somebody hearing me here?
Yes.
I said your body is not you.
Hallelujah.
You are different from your body. And when you have self-control, you can bring your body under subjection.
Yes.
He says, so that after I have done everything, I will not be a castaway. There are some players, there are some teams that they saw some players they paid extra money for them to put on the team. But right now they can't use them. Some guys that they bought them, they were super. But I thought they came to that thing, the work just happened. They are eating too much, enjoying, they start getting fat, they can't play well. And what do? They put them aside. And somebody else will take your place. You see, if you don't have self-control, God will give your place to somebody.
Amen.
Don't let somebody take your place.
Amen.
Don't let somebody take your place. And what Jesus said to Judas Iscariot, he said, another man will take your place. And what happened to Judas? He never had self-control. He couldn't control himself over money business. So they used the same money business to make him to betray his master. Ever since, he couldn't control himself over small, small offering. So he saw 30 pieces of silver. He was ready to sell his master. If you can't exercise self-control now, I look at a lot of people, some of you are looking at very good Christians, people praising you. If you get to a miracle, a different story. You know how many pastors are in a miracle and their story is different? By the time they get to a miracle, they see the woman in the nest and they say, that woman, I wish her. She's been witching in my life ever since. And they divorce you because they see something else, no control. When pastors want to divorce, it's easy. Just make your wife a wish. Is somebody hearing me? Paul said, I put my body under control. But I keep under my body and bring it into subjection. Lest that by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway. And some people preaching and healing and miracles happening, they are satisfied. But you don't know that your lifestyle, if you can't have self-control, your lifestyle alone can drive people away. Your lifestyle alone can fear people from coming to God. Keep them away. Keep them away. Look at Philippians 3:14. He said, I press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. I press. Self-control is not an easy thing. It is not something that will happen by itself. You have to purpose in your heart. You have to purpose in your mind. You have to do it. Nobody can do self-control for you. Are you hearing me? Nobody can do self-control for you. You yourself have to put your body under subjection and press. I press. Let's look at 1 Corinthians chapter 6 that was read to me. It said, all things are lawful unto me, and all things are not expedient. They are lawful, but they are not expedient. Someone will say, I am allowed to do anything. Yes, but not everything is good for you. All things have been lawful. That means you have the freedom to do everything. But it is not expedient to do all things. But not everything is good for you. I could say that I am allowed to do anything. But I am not going to let anything make me a slave. Listen, I can do the same things you can do. But not all things are expedient. Right now, some musician can wear the rocker jeans, they want to tear all over and they stay here to sing. I will still like the old clap for them. But if I do it, I will say something wrong with me. We went to the store in the US and one of my people said, Papa, the jeans correct. I said, yeah, correct. But it's not correct on me. I like jeans. I wear all kinds of jeans, but I don't wear raka. I don't get up pay money to buy tier jeans and can't wear anything. When my jeans used to get torn up, I would find tailor to fix it. And now I go buy tier jeans and wear it. Then I see that the fashion I enter. No, I'm free to wear it. But it is not expedient for me to wear it. Do you know that the same way you are free to eat kuwe on Broad Street with donut, the donut in your left hand, the kuwe in your right hand? You know that I'm free to do it? Eh? Why people passing, the guy people passing in 20, they don't know where you are. Then you go smoke to it. Like the time I was in school. Am I not free to do it too? To eat my kuwe and donut that I like? But it's an expedient for me to do it. No, that's what Bishop is pushing. Why are you saying when Bishop is free? And the Bishop saying that now. You see, that is why people can die for people to even make them legal. But because they don't have self-control, you become disappointed in people you make legal. Imagine one of our major government officials, he got bike on SKD Bolivar. I'll not call him name. You got all of you friendly with him. But he can be right to the Ghana bar and right to the junction there. And he can get drunk. Then you see the beginning carrying him. Then somebody pushing the bike behind him. He can't ride his own bike to go home. They're pushing the bike behind him. Then the other guy they're holding him, carrying him. But he's government official. No self-control. And then when he come on radio, he had to pour him off on everybody. Then he say, he's talking good for the nation. How can you talk good for the nation when you are one of the nation's most disgraced? The reason why we are going nowhere in life is because we lack self-control.
Yes. Thank you, baby.
And then you want to blame the devil for it. We can do fire, yeah, it's good. I want the brother said, okay, fire, it's good. But when you got stupid anointed people, they can't go far. So you need sensible people. Is somebody hearing me? Sensible people. Listen, my desire and my prayer for you, if you listen to all my messages, you will see that I'm interested in transformation.
Yes,
my desire for you is for you to become great.
Amen.
For you to become somebody.
Yeah.
It's not just for you to come to church, I have pain in my back and the pain gone. Now the pain gone, your life didn't go anywhere.
Yes.
There's no difference from the time you have pain and the time you never have pain. You are a mean person who can get under the anointing in the church. 16 times now, 4 times will pick you up. Stay the same. Only thing that happens, you change your clothes.
Hallelujah!
So most of us, we celebrate the falling under the anointing, but we're not celebrating progress in our lives. Even when God himself fighting to help you, because you don't have self-control, you are restraining God. You are restraining God. You are stopping God from taking you where he wants to take you.
Yes.
Do you know God's plan for your life? The Bible says they are good.
Yes.
And not of evil.
Yes.
To bring you to an expected end. That is his plan for you. And he's working out his plan for you. So make sure you imprint it like they good, and print it, you become great. Do you know that when people are talking about 2020, anybody here in 2020 before?
Yes.
Eh? What 2020 really has to do with? Vision. If you go to the hospital and they test in your eyes, they will tell you, you never had 2020 vision. 2020 vision means you can see clear. It means clarity. So you are entering the year where everything about your life is supposed to be clear. and yet you don't have self-control, you will still go be sin. Let me try it first. Self-control. Look at this. He said, look, I'm free to do anything, but it is not expedient. It is not good for me to just do anything I can do. You're making decisions, don't consider anything. Go to the next verse. He says, someone else will say, food is for the stomach. And the stomach is for what? Yes, but God will put an end to both. The body is not to be used for what? What is the body for? Eh? He said, that my own body, that's so what? Y'all leave me alone, I'm my own body. Your own body, but the person who gave you the body to you said, put it under control.
Thank you, my man.
Don't just use it for anything. I will continue this series, but let me tell you something. Eh? Let me tell you something. So many persons here with your eyes and had a business. The business was just there. Nothing coming from out of here. In the place of business, they said nothing coming from out of here. So why are you in something that nothing coming from out of here? You know, some people can stay down to the office for you to pray. I want you to pray for my business. You pray for the business so you can be profit. And I've said this before. Just imagine when you are selling to Cafe. Eh? And you get no self-control. You say a stomach for food. The doctor bill you bought. Sometimes three t-shirt profit at 125. When you sell three t-shirts, you get $125 profit. Especially when we are where you get $75 profit. Are you following me? Then they will just start yelling, a hat. You see what that? The people shoot a hat. I'm a boy, 125. Please get me one board there. So. When a free t-shirt you sold on that day, and the profit was $75. Same person was laughing. Because you can buy a hat. Raise your body hat. One for the power for the fufusu. Your profit gone. Eh? And the profit for the three t-shirts you sold that day. You come against your future profit now. Buy your penance, Kenny. Tennessee? Yeah, for one, you have the Tennessee. Come. I'm about one. Point it out. Give me TV. At the moment, the prophet is starting this way. Coconut candy with ginger. Coconut candy with ginger. Coconut candy. I'm going to say things that your ears say, there you go. That is why most of the good affair people don't make profit. Now, if you don't have self-control to control yourself, you are breaking your business down, then you kind of are looking for delivering prayer. Then we do again with the fire, and the main place to put the fire at your mouth. Tell your neighbor, say self-control. Pastor Wallace, many persons, they don't have self-control and they are just suffering pastors. God bless you, Pastor. What are you welcome? Eh? So your church believes in deliverance, and so we ourselves should just be the fire. Fire. And you yourself, the first time, you, the first day, the opportunity t-shirt for me, the whole profit at 125. When the poor one was saying a hat, the poor for the coupon, the 125 gone. Then the one you said tomorrow, Tennessee candy, you took $60. And again with the ginger in the coconut candy, you took $40. You know anything of tomorrow profit? Then you come on the business, nothing coming out of here. I don't know what happened to the business, and let's pray. Listen, church, we need self-control. If you have a mark, you need self-control. Do you know that most of the people that come to death for money, they are self more expensive when they use the belly? They are looking for help, but they are self very expensive. And all the money says of us put together to help them. They went and bought expensive cell phone. Then they will come tomorrow again. No self-control. You selling your profit not plenty. Then you won't wear the same latest shoes your friends wearing. You can't control yourself. Listen, who am I? A bishop. Now, as a bishop, you know the type of cars I'm supposed to be driving? You know, the electrical wires in my church, ask Brother Hill. Brother Hill, they went to electrify the house. The upstairs, the two floors of the house, they went to electrify. For electrification alone, I spent almost $16,000. Now, because I got something to do, I'm finished here, no light. I didn't even buy light. I didn't even buy some other things here. But just do the wiring of that house. Buy all the things. And do you know that when I had that money in America, and I had to buy about $6,000 wires first, we saw cars. That's my way. Good car to buy. But what will it profit me if I buy the car and bring it? And then the protesting be stagnant. You see, when you don't have self-control, you'll be competing with everybody. Listen, even if I hear the text when someone listens to me, say, hello, Bishop. You're not saying you're interested today. You're not Bishop, you're ready. People don't have self-control. Their anger is overplus. Then they're coming for deliverance for relationship to stay. In the relationship, I dare you, it can break. So I want you to pray. You can't control yourself. You're forced to reply to the man when the man says something. No, but baby, the man can provoke me too much. They find another one that will not provoke me. Any relationship where people can take mess, it can last. Because every relationship must have mess inside. Every relationship must have mess inside. You can leave this man today, you go to another man, he get mess. You leave the woman today, you go to another woman, she got mess. So that mess, you don't want to see that one, forget it. Because every relationship is a labyrinth. Any area you go, you see Dumpa. The only thing is that some of the Dumpa are small and some big. The only prayer should be from Dumpa, shouldn't be Gobachor Dumpa. Control your temperament. In fact, you can ask all of us to testify. Prophetess, tell this woman. They were worried about my anger. You tell the woman, I'm angry, the thing I can do. You're looking for people to testify to your anger. Then you tell your friend. And we now, please tell him. He didn't know me yet. He want to get angry. They will not be good for him. Imagine you're looking for somebody to witness to your anger. How will you get to the mark? How can you get forward? How can you reach your goal if you don't have self-control? So a lot of people, they are making us to pray for businesses and that they won't break it down. You break with a relationship, they are breaking it. You men, you boxer, but you never been in a ring before. Never been in a ring. But then you see no one ready to box. And say, but they're ready for me, I'm praying for wife. I feel it dead, you're looking for. Because anyone that comes to beat them, and your pastor in the lead, they help you to pray for men. Don't worry, your wife will come. And you know the men coming and going. Because each of them can, you take your punch, you go. Self-control is what we need. One guy told me he was leaving his wife. He said, Papi, I can't make it. Anytime a woman calls me, she asks me, where are you? And the first question I can ask her to tell you hello. All the women see. How many women can tell their partner hello? Are you here? How many of you women cannot call your man and say hello? They hard. The person, baby, where are you? Not everything. They want to know where are you first. If you leave your wife for where are you after you're not married, then you come to see her. Where are you? Self-control.
Amen.
Is what we need.
Amen.
Self-control.
Amen.
If you must reach your goal, if you must become somebody in life, self-control. And what Paul said, I became everything to every man so that I can win some. For the Jews, I became Jews. To the Gentile, I became like a Gentile. The only thing is that I know that I'm submitting to the law of Christ. Anything. I was just saying, as a bishop, they call it pastor. Yes. Do you know that the people I was teaching in Woodridge and Tipotec and other schools before, and they can still see me, brother, who had a day? I still answer. Nothing changed. Yes, that's why I said, the man I'm brother, the man I'm bishop, I say, forget what I think, like, the same thing. You not seen God's grandchild before? Eh? How many of you have seen God's grandchild before? Why no granger? He sent Jesus. Jesus came to die for us. And yet we are his brothers. If we are all children of God, then that means we are brothers and sisters. So why would you get angry when somebody call you brother? Oh, you come and talk to us. What happened? When they call you bishop, what do you prophet? People don't have self-control. When you have self-control, you can bring yourself to any level to accomplish something. Some of you that cry suffering, where you should start from, you don't want to start from there. I don't know how many of you that started climbing ladder from the top. Always start from the bottom to get to the top. Certain levels you should start from, you can't start from there. But then when people see us, you know, man, we're really enjoying. divine all over. Yeah. That's what you see there. I just ask Lisa, you know, she sold her flag. She was forced to go and let a big time girl from Morovia at home, but she was forced to lend her a car and started taking it to people's offices. From there, she guided the book of flesh. She started sewing. She even sewed for some people in the church before. Now, where was the seamstress? She did all of those things. We used to travel by road, go to pastor, go to them, they put us anywhere. We sleep there. And then Pastor Moto won top beginning at the post. When you wear a dress, you get a French makeup. And now so I asked that truth, you know, when there was the first time Pastor Moto was interpreting for me in at the post, I know he didn't what I was doing more. And I said, praise the Lord, bro, you, Jevish, I didn't even find out related to myself. And then, you know, seeing I heard this thing in my brain, I said, oh, I can still have brain in this room. And I said, well, I'm a pure boy. I said, we used to go by road. Go to sleep down there, we take night bus the next day. We move on. We get some place that we sleep on mat. Alright, I went to Benny, the hotel in Apple, he said, I said, yeah. All I've been here soon. But he said, I was willing to sleep on mats. I was willing to sleep anywhere. You start from there. You need to bring your body, 1 Corinthians 9:27, under subjection. You control your body. Amen. Your body is not you. You are somebody else. You control your body. Amen. You don't allow your body to dictate to you.
Thank you.
If you have feelings or symptoms, or you know, the thing flew into a ceremony, I was coming back and made a start in ceremony. My whole ass started swinging. I said, what up is over? I balance. Three. I got home. I said, no, do I feel nothing? I sent for the little husband to give me my pressure no more. I said, okay, that won't balance. But I mean, back in there. I went to the hospital. They said, oh, you can, your stars level go on. You got to start eating where you're eating for food, eating there for something else. So now, but I am free to eat for food. Eh?
Yeah.
I'm free to eat well rest. Yeah. I'm free to eat garri. Free to eat anything. But it's an expedient for me to do now.
No,
but even on that, I can't ban it, you know. You see, not all things. You want to get somewhere, learn to do something. I always tell myself I'll be using my whole cars until and read my project song. But you can't be doing project in your computer, but then I'm in their supercar, I say I need two cars. If I go anywhere, I can't carry my sheet paper, I will borrow one of your good Jeep, and you say I go there. Nobody know I borrow the Jeep. They invited me, they saw me coming. Instead of me competing with your work, they begin to get good Jeep. I had a pastor on my Jeep that would be powerful. That's too big competition. Learn to control yourself. Because of lack of self-control, most of you are struggling today. Your body is not for sexual immorality. Yeah, it is. It's for the Lord. You serve the Lord with your body. If you can't control your body, you put yourself in all kinds of things. I was telling them on Wednesday, and I want to close with that story. I want to go minister somewhere. Let me close with that story. I was telling them on Wednesday, if you can't listen to God, something else will dictate to you. A girl on Facebook, she saw this guy. Handsome girl, they start chatting. She checked the guy profile. he went on chatting. True story I'm telling you. And the guy, they set up dates. They went to the restaurant. After that, they did to hang out again. They went to hang out. After hanging out, they went to the guy's house. He started taking his leg there. Everything happened good. The guy showed her love. He spoiled her with love. When she was leaving, the guy gave her some money, took her to the bus stop. Kids saw everything. She said, no, nobody ever spoiled me like this. She praised him with everything. When she went home and she walked out, the guy said, I've arrived. She sent a message, he make a reply. One messenger, he make a reply. The first thing she noticed that they went black off. They went for one more, she started feeling sick. She couldn't get the guy, you know, oh my God, wait a minute, we had a good time today, he keeps me well and everything, and nothing working. I can't even get the man again. After 2 months, she went to the hospital, they tested her, she was pregnant, and she was HIV positive. Coming from the hospital, she all confused that she should die. Self-control. Another girl, very clever. Finished with putting to everything. And she applied. The man agreed to give her the job. But he said to her, let's meet at the hotel for the interview. And I booked the hotel room. Gave her the room number. She went to the reception office. She climbed up, went to the hotel room. And the guy said, you know they're gonna draw, people can't give it free. And a big time money job. And you'll be in charge of all my cash and everything. So we gotta be close. He convinced her, she agreed. She said, let me go in the bathroom to change. She went in the bathroom, prepared herself and came. But I thought she came and said, I can't trust you much. Because if you can give yourself cheaply to me like this, you can put now with anybody and destroy my business. The man said, I'm a Christian, I'm a child of God, I can't do this thing. He walked out at the door. If I walked out of the hotel and left her, she went back to her mom because she was so short the job. Her mom said, how everything went well? They didn't have anything about it. She was crying. If I had known self-control. See what she missed. How can I trust you when you agree to sleep with me? Yeah, I should trust you with the money for my business. Any man can convince you, you give it to them. Self-control. I will start here today. Stand for your feet. Don't forget, any of you that God touched your heart, buy some of the chairs and bring it, okay? And God will bless you. Amen. At this level, not everything, I got a good program for you. To do chair day program, what I'm doing. Just buy a chair and bring it and put it in. You know the colors already. And God will surely bless you. Amen. Amen. I want you to pray one prayer for the Lord. Help me with self-control. I don't have time to take you to Galatians. I say, Lord, help me to have self-control. That I'll be able to control my body. I won't do just anything that will hinder me